Since the Earth is a round object, we often use an orientation system based on degrees, latitude and longitude. Latitude lines, also called parallels, measure the distance north and south of the equator. You can think of it like a ladder going up and down. The parallels are measured from the center of the Earth's spheroid using simple geometry. The equator is located at 0 degrees latitude. Lines of latitude start at 0 degrees at the equator and end at 90 degrees at the north and south poles. The North Pole is located at north 90 degrees, while the South Pole is located at south 90 degrees, also shown as negative 90 degrees. Each degree of latitude can be broken down into 60 minutes, and each minute can further be broken down into 60 seconds. The parallels are always an equal distance apart, so we can calculate that each second of latitude is about 30 meters. Longitude lines, also called meridians, measure the distance east and west of the prime meridian. In the United States, we measure from the prime meridian in Greenwich, in the United Kingdom. This is 0 degrees of longitude. If you travel east, the degree of longitude would increase until it reached 180 degrees on the opposite side of the globe from the prime meridian. This half of the Earth is called the Eastern Hemisphere. North America sits west of the prime meridian, within the Western Hemisphere. That means our longitude lines will always be shown as west or negative. It is not uncommon for the negative to be left off when communicating latitude and longitude within the US, since it is assumed. If you are entering a latitude and longitude on a map and you want it to end up in the right continent, that negative becomes more important to include. Each degree of longitude can be broken down into minutes and seconds as well, but lines of longitude are not parallel to each other like lines of latitude. They are farthest apart at the equator, then narrow to a point at the poles. So how do we give our location using latitude and longitude? We measure away from set reference points on the globe. The position of any location on Earth can be given in coordinates, with the latitude shown first and the longitude shown second. Let's say you're in a canyon in Utah. Your coordinates are 39 degrees, 25 minutes, 58 seconds north of the equator, and 111 degrees, 40 minutes, 30 seconds west of the prime meridian. If you accidentally switch the direction, say from north to south, you would end up in the ocean off the coast of South America. You may see latitude and longitude structured a few different ways. From our previous example, you can see that each different format has slightly different numbers. These are all the same location, but you might need to do some simple math to get the numbers into the same format. Remember that the decimals represent portions of a minute, so you can simply multiply the decimals by 60 to convert into minutes and seconds. Divide by 60 to convert minutes and seconds to decimals. Often, mapping programs will accept latitude and longitude in a variety of formats. If possible, communicate with the resources you are working with to make sure you are collecting latitude and longitude in the format they need. Now, with a little knowledge about latitude and longitude under your belt, you can actually get a general idea of where you are on the Earth just by looking at the number. Let's say you have a small latitude and a large negative longitude. You know you would be somewhere close to the equator and very far from the prime meridian. If you had a higher latitude and a smaller negative longitude, you would be near the prime meridian, closer to the North Pole. You can even do this at a small scale. If you were at a known location and you are trying to direct someone to a place that is directly west of you, you will know that the latitude will stay the same, and the longitude will increase since the point is farther away from the prime meridian than you are. The best way to get really comfortable with this is just to scroll around the world on your favorite mapping program that shows the latitude and longitude of your cursor. Paper maps are often called 7.5-minute quadrangles because they cover the area of 7.5 minutes of latitude and longitude. You can see the markings on the side of the map that show the latitude and longitude values, and in the center of the map, you can see some plus signs that help you keep track of the breakpoints between minutes and seconds. Getting the latitude and longitude from a map can be inexact. We have to rely on the resolution of the tick marks to pinpoint our location, and as we've learned, each second can represent up to 30 meters. Using global positioning technology, we are able to obtain highly accurate location information.